Summit, and I tell you what, it got off to a great start with Jim Bland and also with this gentleman right here. I'd like to introduce Kevin Smith, the IT officer for Tritium, CTO. CTO, yeah, there you go. Kevin, thanks for taking a few minutes to speak with us.
Hey, it's been a pleasure to be here. Big fan of you guys, actually. I love your show. And this has been an exciting summit, hasn't it?
It has. It's been a great, great summit. And it's exciting times. I mean, there's a lot of changes going on, and it's sort of rock and roll. But how, I mean, you know, for our community might not know, this guy's written like 6 or 7 books. I mean, he's done so much cool stuff. But tell us a little bit about your background, what you did. And you actually, I understand, we're friends with John Sublett way back in the day.
Yeah. So for about 20 years before I came to Tritium, I was working for the Department of Defense and Intelligence Community, writing software, building secure information sharing solutions. Yeah, it's pretty cool. And I remember when John told me that, he said, hey, I'm going to start this new company. I'm moving to Richmond. And over the years, I just kept on visiting Tritium. And it just took me this long to get here. So I got here about 4 years ago. They needed some help with some cybersecurity stuff. And actually, it was great. We have such a great team at Tritium. And it's really fun to work there.
You guys were kind of like, I know we visited John and Nino and some of the others up in Richmond. And so we've heard the stories. I mean, you guys were kind of like the entrepreneurial company before entrepreneurial was cool. I mean, with the pool tables and the hanging out, like the Grateful Dead of controls or something like that, right? And yeah, so you guys definitely have that vibe. But you're right. And I think this is what you bring to the table is cybersecurity is one of the trends Kenny and I have been tracking for a while. People kind of don't understand it. But, you know, one of the things you talked about was how you're sort of hardening the platform. And I think our community is going to want to hear that. For the Niagara 4.6, you guys are really taking some steps to make it more secure.
Yeah, so big challenges with information security, as you know, right? Yep. Lots of cyber attacks coming out, lots of malware. And so one of the big challenges is making security easier for integrators and administrators. And so one of the first things we did is to try secure by default. So we added that capability in Niagara 4. So everything defaults to the most secure configurations. So you don't have to be a security expert when you're setting up Niagara. Other things we've added, secure boot. Code signing, digital integrity validation at runtime, malware protection, lots of new cybersecurity controls that we're adding, stronger ciphers, and we're constantly adding more capabilities. At the same time, we're also trying to educate people.
Sure.
Because security still takes some getting up to speed, so we have a lot of documentation that we put on our website. And we have a great cybersecurity team. So. We have a lot of people focused on making sure the product is not only secure, but easy to use and easy to configure.
Well, Kevin, you have a lot of resources. I remember the first time I saw you was on a Tritium talk where everybody's worried about cybersecurity, and it's really refreshing and you know, brings their faith back that we've got very good people taking very you know, concerted efforts to make us more secure. But you came on as a CTO, and I'm sorry, well, you started in security, but now your role has expanded.
Mm-hmm.
And you were the keynote speaker number 2 yesterday, and it was just, you really caught everybody's attention by taking people from where we're at now and some of the things that you have planned for the future. So what would talk about a little bit about what, where's Niagara going and how it's just going to get better, perspective that you got to keep investing in the cybersecurity measures, and then you would do that to keep your software current.
Yeah, keeping your software current is really important, because the most secure version of Niagara is the latest version of Niagara, right?
Right.
Patching your system, always keeping your software current is important. But wow, we have a lot of things that we've been focusing on. So one, focusing on Niagara Cloud, expanding that. So we built this foundation that took a while, but we had to build like secure authentication services, a lot of security, flexible mechanism for scaling. And now we're building on top of that. So we have here at the summit, and hopefully you saw it, a really cool prototype that we have of Niagara Cloud that allows you to change things, view settings, from your browser or from your phone. And so our long-term vision is we want to provide the capabilities that Niagara Supervisor has today, but in a horizontally scalable way. So you can do it in the cloud or on-prem, right?
Right.
And so that's exciting. Our Edge story is also pretty exciting, too. We have our Edge 10 product, which is going to be released this year. Really excited about it, because what it proves is you can now take Niagara and you can put it on a lower-level Edge controller or an Edge device, so a VAV controller, right? Or a boiler or a humidifier or a fuel pump. And so we've actually proven that out with Edge 10. And so this means that our community will be able to not only have Jaces in their building, but lower level Edge devices that you can program with one tool. And so because we were planning for that, we added a lot of new capabilities in Niagara for managing lots of Niagara systems. So we have the bulk deploy capability that I showed you demonstrated during the keynote. And that's really neat, because you can load a spreadsheet with a lot of devices and all their configuration information, linkages to schedules, graphics, and all that stuff, load it up and just watch it deploy in minutes. And so a lot of capabilities like that that we're really excited about.
Well, if you start for our community out there, for the Edge 10, what makes that really, really exciting for me is the fact that now you can put analytics on the Edge.
Yep.
The fact with the bulk deploys, if you've got a national account, you got multiple banks, multiple fast food restaurants, the price point is such that you can put these in, you get full blown. It's like you have the best of all worlds now can come down to a smaller footprint. And with the bulk deploy, you can update very, very quickly and efficiently.
Yeah, and I'm really excited. A lot of people know about our portability software development kit. It allows you to take Niagara and put it on your own hardware, but now people take it and put it on Edge devices. And so that's going to be really exciting for our community, I think.
Well, Kevin, you said some really cool stuff, too, in your presentation about the mobile-first strategy. I really like that, and people-oriented strategies, where the whole thing is to improve the customer's experience.
Yeah.
And how you're allowing the developers and the Niagara community to create applications that are very friendly, and Niagara's very friendly, so that they can take advantage of that. And the potential out there was extraordinary. Tell us about when the people take these new opportunities with Niagara, the market potential. Tell us a little bit about that.
Sure, yeah, I talked a little bit about the occupant experience, and we have to look at our buildings more as more than just saving money on energy, reducing facilities costs, but it could be a revenue generator for our business, right? A revenue engine. Yeah. And so part of that is going to be the mobile experience, because almost everybody has a mobile phone today, right? So you could build a mobile app on your phone, and it can take location service data from your phone, information about you, and integrate with other systems. And so there are a lot of applications here at the summit that are showing how they have extended Niagara to their mobile device and using it in really neat ways. And so I think there's going to be a lot of neat opportunities for people to do that. And I shared a couple ideas at the keynote. I don't know if they're very good, but the great thing about this community is everybody has great ideas.
Yeah.
Like, there are innovators in this community, and I'm just so excited about some of the conversations I've had with them.
Well, you had given an example, I don't know if this is right on track, but that Amazon, where you have that experience, you can go in and shop and walk out. And there's no cashiers, it's all there. And it's all been, there's a lot of heavy duty work being done in the front end of it. But once you have that mobile app and you go into a store, get what you want, you walk out, it's already followed you, it's already made the transactional arrangements, and it sends you a bill on your, you get a cloud bill to your bank or your iPhone.
Yeah, and that's Amazon Go. It's the first automated grocery store. And so really neat. And all they did really was take a lot of the technologies that are already here and integrate them together. And so you can identify who it is by their phone, and you can figure out where they are in the store, and you can kind of associate that with what they're picking up. But, I mean, it's really neat, because the Niagara community does that today. They take technologies and they integrate it together and they build solutions. Some solutions I'm blown away when I look at them. I mean, they're really innovative and exciting.
Well, I think the deal is, and you know, we're just at an apex where everything is getting ready to shift. And you guys use the analogy of, you know, you're a conductor.
Yep.
And I would use an analogy maybe along the lines of, you know, we've been, you know, drawing on walls and caves, right?
Yep.
And now all of a sudden you guys are giving us canvases and paintbrushes and all this other stuff to create great art. And I would encourage our community, the integrators, you need to think of yourself as an artist, because you can create anything with the tools you're given. And I hear your request for the community is, yeah, be an artist.
Yeah.
Create it. We'll give you the paints. We'll give you the paintbrushes. We'll give you everything and do it. And I think that's mandatory if you want to survive. You have to think different. I think one of the last conferences, I think one of you guys said status quo means you're dead. So
you got to be changing.
Well, talk about that. Listen, you've written several books. Tell us a little bit about your books and sort of what did that teach you? How did you get interested in writing? And what has writing books taught you?
So it's funny. I kind of fell into it. So at first, I had a friend who had a book contract, and he said, I'm behind. Publishing company's really upset. Can you write some chapters? And so it was actually a book called Java Application Frameworks. And so I did that, and right after that, the publishing company said, hey, we need help with another book. And I said, okay, sure. So I helped with that. But it's funny, over the years, I've done Java programming books, and then user interface books and XML books and big data analytics and semantic web. And it's funny because now I look at some of the technologies that we're using at Tritium, right. And I have a lot of background in a lot of those technologies, which is really crazy. It's just a really neat coincidence. But the reason I did it, though, is, and the reason I enjoyed doing it, is I like explaining things to people, and I also like learning, because whenever you're teaching something, or even whenever you're writing something, you have to understand the material really well to explain it. And I always feel like I'm smarter about something at the end of a project like that than I was at the beginning. So I enjoy that.
I want to talk a minute about the book, The Semantic Web, and sort of how that applies, because you made another big announcement about your sort of affiliation with Project Haystack. And again, you know, knowing now what we know about the book and what that was about, it really is like divine intervention or something, right?
Sure, yeah. So Semantic Web is all about applying tagging and metadata, right, to information and data so that you can really connect the dots in all your information and use it in solutions. And so so Project Haystack, you know, Tritium is a member of Haystack. It's a great initiative for standardizing tagging in buildings. And we're really excited about another initiative that's happening with Haystack and ASHRAE BACnet Committee, and another standard organization called Brick Schema, which is an ontology or an RDF vocabulary that is a semantic web vocabulary. But it was kind of focused on the same area as Haystack. And I was looking at it for a while and thinking, well, man, these could be two competing standards, which isn't all that great, right?
Right.
But the fact that they're working together, that's going to be great, because we're going to have one global standard. All devices can really speak the same language, and we can harness that in a truly open potential. So really, really good stuff.
Yeah, and I think what it means for our community, for engineers, architects, and everything else, it's not that you can't get data and do analytics. It's just expensive to do it that way with an agreed upon schema.
Yep.
It's just going to make it more affordable.
Yep, absolutely.
To me, I see Niagara now becoming so scalable that what used to be considered maybe a large to very large application, enterprise level, is coming down into the light commercial buildings where these potentials, the Niagara stack, can now be used on very small buildings and be effective. So integrators have greater volume, because we know that there's a big market out there for smaller buildings, you know, and that a lot of these buildings that we drive past every day with the rooftops on them are being controlled by thermostats or less. And now we have a chance to see the integrators now have a huge opportunity to take that application mentality, the mobile first strategy, and take that to heart in these tremendous, what would you guess a market for these, a new market now that we have this potential?
Heck, I think the sky's the limit. Use your imagination.
Right.
The great thing is, I think we can scale in many different ways. People can use this in many different areas. We're really just trying to give options for a lot of people.
Right.
And you mentioned the awards. There's some really exciting projects going on, right? And we really wanted to take this as an opportunity to recognize people in the community. And so we had this contest where people submitted some of their projects and some of their products. And I'm excited to see who the winner is. So.
Yeah. the commitment that Tritium made to Project Haystack and the openness means that there's going to be more and more people playing. So the Niagara community is going to go into places where it was never intended to go. In other words, it started out in the building area, started out in building automation, energy efficiency, and now we're seeing things that are happening from all these deflection points from other industries coming. And talk a little bit about that, because I think the potential is enormous.
Yeah, what was really neat was something that happened at lunch today. So I was sitting at a table with lunch, and one person said, "Hey, I'm struggling with how to do this." And then someone else at the table goes, "Oh, I've handled that." And they just started talking. And so it's really neat. Now, you mentioned that we're the canvas and they're the artist, right? And so for me to just witness this interaction among our community of people who are saying, "Oh, I had that problem before. This is how I solved it."
Right.
And then they're exchanging business cards. And so there's so much expertise in this industry. And people are just playing off each other and helping each other and sharing best practices. And actually, that's what was going on here at the summit today. A lot of great best practice presentations. And I really think this community is working together to support each other, especially as they're solving new problems, entering new industries, and it's fun. Yesterday, I saw your interview with the Godfather of Niagara, and I loved it. And also, you guys came up with this great idea a couple months ago. I think it was, what was it? It was
Ed in a box. Ed Merwin in a box.
And so it was something like, I think Tritium should probably take this product to market. What it is you put Ed Merwin in your pocket, and he's listening on the other end, right?
Yeah.
And so you go into, and you're talking to a customer, and Ed is kind of whispering things that you should say.
What was that book, Survey of, you know, there's a book, and they made a point, Steve Martin pointed, where the guy was really, he wasn't very handsome, but he was really good at talking and was wooing the girl, so he would talk in his ear and tell him what to say. So imagine, I mean, because Ed, you know, Ed, I got on that idea because Ed said eventually he wants to retire and work at somebody's city counter. I said, "All right, we'll make whatever county you want. Just come to Atlanta." But, I mean, you know, but you could deploy that technology literally. You're going to make a sales call. You got the little earpiece in. I mean, the newscasters do it, right? Ed's listening. He goes, "Okay, ask him this question. Do that." So, yeah, I think that would be a great value added. You guys would revolutionize the business with it.
Don't laugh. That's coming. That Google Glass stuff.
Yeah, I think Ed in your pocket is coming to market. Maybe we'll announce it at the next summit, or maybe before.
That sounds great, man. That sounds great. So listen, man, thank you so much, Kevin. You guys are doing a great job. Love what you're up to. And we'd love to have you come on the Smart Buildings podcast sometime with us. So.
Hey, it sounds great. Sounds great.
Thanks, Kevin. Appreciate it.
Take care.
All right, man.
All right, Kevin. Thank you very much.
Thank you.